The search has ended for the last person missing from the sunken luxury yacht off Sicily. Divers on Friday found a final body believed to be that of 18-year-old daughter of British tech magnate Mike Lynch. The yacht, carrying 22 passengers and crew, sank early Monday during a violent storm. Only 15 survived. Lynch had invited his friends on the yacht, including Jonathan Bloomer, the chairman of Morgan Stanley International, to celebrate his recent acquittal in a U.S. fraud trial. Let's check on European markets first. They are seeing gains in afternoon trade, with most sectors in positive territory. The German DAX and the French CAC 40 are up around 0.5% each. As for Wall Street, futures are also in the green, with the Dow Jones and the S&P 500 poised for modest weekly gains. In the spotlight this Friday, the opening of the Jackson Hole Symposium in Wyoming, where central bankers from around the world are set to gather. The main event, Fed Chief Jerome Powell's speech, with investors hoping he will give a clearer signal on the pace of easing. Analysts, however, believe Powell's keynote speech could be less about further shaping rate cut expectations and more about assessing where the world's biggest economy stands. Asian markets ended Friday trade on a mixed note ahead of the Jackson Hole Symposium. The Nikkei 225 rose 0.4% after data showed Japan's headline inflation was unchanged in July, while core inflation picked up for a third straight month. So-called core inflation, however, which strips out prices of both fresh food and energy and is tracked by the Bank of Japan, dipped below 2% for the first time in nearly 2 years. Meanwhile, a notable stock movement in the region, Hong Kong listed shares of Alibaba climbed 1.2% after its shareholders approved a plan to upgrade its Hong Kong listing to primary status. Now, it's a move that is expected to attract huge investments from mainland China. Here are some stocks to watch out for. We are monitoring shares of Nestle after the company announced that its CEO, Mark Schneider, is stepping down. He will be replaced by company veteran Lauren Frex. Shares of the food and drink giant slumped 2%. Also in focus, shares of Hugo Boss after its second biggest shareholder, fashion retailer Frasers, filed a bid to acquire more shares in the German company. Now, this sent Hugo Boss shares higher by 2%. We are also keeping a close watch on Qualcomm, which has entered into a deal to acquire the 4G Internet of Things technology of French firm Sequans Communications. Qualcomm shares are up 1% in pre-market trading. The Philippine Anti-Poverty Commission reports the government is on track to reduce the country's poverty incidence. NAPC lead convener Secretary Lopez Santos III says poverty incidence in 2023 was at 15.5%. Now, poverty incidence is defined as the number of Filipinos whose per capita income cannot meet basic food and non-food needs. Santos also backs a review of the government's methods for identifying food-poor individuals in the country. That's after NEDA Secretary Arsenio Balisacan earlier drew flak for saying people spending more than 64 pesos for 3 meals a day are not food-poor.
Ino-offer namin yung NAPSI, particularly yung mga 14 basic sector na magamit itong mekanismong ito upang magkaroon ng komprehensibong konsultasyon. Ito yung pangunahing titingnan ng National Anti-Poverty Commission upang hindi lang i-review yung poverty threshold, but kailangan nating magtulong-tulong para maiangat itong mga bilang nitong mahihirap na pamilyang Pilipino.